Hi, Stephen.
Natalie, how are you this morning?
Very well, thank you. How are you?
Okay. Happy to be talking to one of the hottest stars in movies today,
Thank you.
Natalie Dormer. Natalie, where are you?
I'm in New York right
Oh,
now, my
you're in New
love.
York. Well, I'm in New York too,
Oh,
so
are
I
you?
just come on over.
Yeah, I'll get a cab now.
Right. Well, your career is so red hot, and now you're in the movie everybody's talking about that opens tomorrow, The Counselor. Tell us about what you're playing in it.
Well, I'm playing one of the characters that comes in as a tool used by one of the lead characters that you see here behind me. A stellar cast, obviously.
Obviously, yeah.
And I sort of come in, I'm part of the power play and the politics of what's happening in the movie, which is about a lawyer who gets way in over his head in a drug cartel deal that goes badly wrong. Really exciting, dark, sexy script. As I said before, incredible cast, the opportunity to work with Ridley Scott. I was just overjoyed to be a part of it, basically.
Right, and it's Michael Fassbender is the guy you're talking about, right?
As the count, who is the counselor, who is the
Yes,
lawyer? Yes,
right.
he is. But I didn't work with Michael. Well, it later turned out, transpired that I shot a little viral scene with him that I think has been released in the last week or so. But I worked on the movie with Brad Pitt and Cameron Diaz. So
Oh, well, not too shabby. Brad Pitt and Cameron Diaz
there
and
are
my
worse. There are worse ways to
And Javier Bardem
spend a
and
day.
Penelope Cruz and you, all in the same film. Great. And of course, most of our viewers know you from Game of Thrones.
Indeed,
I know, and
just a
I've
small
never
show,
seen it, but
a tiny
now,
show.
since I'm talking to you, I've got to see it. I've got to tell. Now, tell us about the character. You're playing Marjorie in that?
Yes, I play a young woman called Marjorie Tyrell, who is a would-be queen of Westeros. She's got her eye, and her family have got their eye very firmly on the Iron Throne, on ruling. So she's engaged to a rather unsavory character at the moment, and then in the next season you'll see the big day and everything that transpires from that point. So
What season is it now?
they're currently shooting season four. I've been released. I've finished everything that I'm doing with them because I'm now shooting Hunger Games, Mockingjay. So, but
Right.
yeah.
On top of Game of Thrones, you're in the Hunger
Well, apparently I'm only taking work at the moment that has game in the title. So,
What
but
fun!
yeah, a lot of fun.
And what are you playing in the Hunger Games?
In The Hunger Games, I'm playing a filmmaker, a film director by the name of Cressida, who is set to follow around Katniss, to follow around Jennifer Lawrence, in aiding to film her as propaganda to aid the rebellion. So
Ah, I
a lot of
see.
fun, and a big departure from how people would know me or see me as Marjorie. So
Right. And you went to drama school in England.
I did.
So you are a trained actress at a school that I always had a great respect for, but isn't there anymore, Webber Douglas.
No, you're right. It doesn't exist anymore, Weber. No, it doesn't.
Oh, that's so sad. But in drama school, did they prepare you for all of these? I mean, you played Anne Boleyn in The Tudors and, now Game of Thrones. I mean, did they teach you how to do, I guess, all that classical stuff?
I'm a stage actress first and
Ah.
foremost. That's what I trained to do, is I'm a stage actress. And this wonderful camera career that I'm having at the moment sort of happened accidentally on the way. A wonderful accident.
Well, because you're so
So,
beautiful, my
oh,
dear.
well, thank you. You'll make me blush. But I try and get back to the stage as often as I can because
Oh, good
it's
for
my first
you.
love. But,
Me
as long
too.
as
I'm a
you're
drama critic too for the drama desk, so I
Are
can
you
vouch for you.
really? You're
Yeah.
happiest when you're in the theatre, are you? There you go.
Yeah. And I have to explain to our viewers that we can hear each other, but we can't see
See
each
each
other, so
other.
I can't see how lovely and beautiful you look at the moment.
And I
But
can't
you're.
see how lovely and beautiful you look right
Oh
now,
my God, no.
either.
This hour of the morning, we have to do these things so early, but in New York it's not that early.
It's all right. We've had our massive pint of New York coffee already, both of us, I'm sure. So,
Right. So, and Anne playing Anne Boleyn in The Tudors. Oh my God. I mean, You know, you were talking about the long dresses.
Yeah, I mean, it's just, you know, most of America is most familiar with me for costume dramas, for corsets and long skirts. And, you know, my career has been much more diverse than that. But it just happens that America mainly know me for that kind of role. So the beauty of, at the moment, is with Hunger Games and things like Elementary and The Counselor coming out tomorrow, you know, people are starting to be able to see me in a slightly different light, and it gets me out of the corsets a bit too, which is a little bit more comfortable.
Right. Well, they can all see how beautiful you are all the time. One of our fastest rising stars and one of the most beautiful, Natalie Dormer, thank you so much this morning from The Stephen Holt Show.
Nice to meet you, Stephen.
Have a fabulous.
Bye. Take care.